Hey everyone, thanks for joining me for another episode of Healthzone with Gilbert Cheah. I'm Gilbert Cheah, I am the editor of Healthzone Singapore, a Facebook page that focuses on health and wellness issues, specifically curated from a Singapore and regional perspective. This week, I'm going to talk to you about the forgotten epidemic. You know, with COVID-19 all around us, it's easy to forget that there are other deadly diseases that the world is also living with. And one of the most deadly has infected over 75 million people and killed over 33 million. That's a mortality rate of over 44%, which is hugely over the rate of COVID. This other global pandemic is HIV. And for many years, this virus was feared more than any other, as it killed so many and spread so fast. But today, HIV seems to have been almost forgotten and is in fact ignored by many people, even though it continues to be a killer disease. Why is this? And what is the danger of ignoring this disease? Today, we will look at HIV and what you should know about it. In Singapore, there are currently over 8,600 people with HIV. And of this, more than 2,000 have passed away, which is a fatality rate of about 25%. But because HIV causes many common infections that become fatal, there are likely many deaths over the years that are not attributed to HIV. Unlike COVID, which is a largely respiratory condition that spreads through fluid droplets when an infected person speaks, coughs, or sneezes, the HIV virus is sexually transmitted through bodily fluids and also through blood transfusions and the sharing of hypodermic needles. Now, HIV attacks and destroys our body's own infection-fighting immune cells. And as a result, the body cannot fight off viruses and bacteria, and patients die from even common infections that ordinarily would not kill people. And today, even 40 years after the first case appeared, there is still no vaccine. However, there are effective treatments that have made this disease one that people can live with instead of die from. HIV medications can suppress the virus by preventing it from multiplying. And although the virus is still present in the body, it can be at such low levels that the immune system can recover and effectively fight infections again. This treatment for HIV is called antiretroviral therapy, or ART, A-R-T for short. ART involves taking a combination of HIV medications every day. This allows most people with HIV to live normal lives. In addition, the viral load in the body can fall to such low levels that people with HIV are unable to even transmit the disease to their sexual partners. In addition to preventing sexual transmission of HIV, another benefit of taking HIV medication is that it reduces the risk of infected mothers passing it onto their child during pregnancy and delivery. Before the medication was available, pregnant women would pass the virus to their babies, and there were many children born with HIV, and many died after short lives. But now, if women are on HIV medication throughout pregnancy, labor, and delivery, and if HIV medication is given to the baby for 4 to 6 weeks after delivery, the risk of transmission from the mother to the child can be reduced to 1% or less. As a result of the medical progress through the years, HIV has gone from being one of the most dreaded diseases on earth to one that has almost been forgotten by the general public. In fact, we've met young people in Singapore who have not even heard of HIV and are unaware of the virus or what it does. Now, the question is this lack of awareness a problem? And the answer is a definite yes. Because although we have ways to treat those infected with the virus, HIV is still potentially very dangerous. There have so far been a fatality rate of about 25% here, so it is a killer disease, and being unaware of the virus is one of the most dangerous situations we can be in. And this is because the medications that treat HIV and make it a manageable condition instead of a fatal one work best when infected people start taking them at an early stage in the disease, preferably within 6 months of getting infected. Starting treatment as soon as possible is important because it will protect your immune system from damage and will give you the best chance of staying strong and healthy. As with most medical treatments, it's much better to start earlier before too much damage is done to the body. But the problem is that most people do not even know they may be HIV positive, and most of them go years without knowing, and therefore, they are not getting this medication. Let's look at the numbers for Singapore. In the first 10 months of this year, there were 220 new HIV cases, and more than half of them, 54%, had late-stage HIV when they were diagnosed. This means that the majority did not even know they were HIV positive for a long period. According to the Ministry of Health, the majority were detected through tests done during medical care, with only 15% of cases discovered through self-initiated HIV screening. This means that only a small minority had gone for HIV testing on their own accord. The majority of those who went for tests on their own accord were gay men. And this brings us to the widespread belief that HIV is something that only affects gay men. Now, while HIV has been a virus that predominantly affected men who have sex with men, or MSM, male-to-female and female-to-male sexual transmission is also common. In fact, of the new cases of HIV infection in Singapore this year, the Ministry of Health identified that 46% were from homosexual transmission, 40% were from heterosexual transmission, and 10% from bisexual transmission. At one time, the media and governments were running information campaigns frequently about HIV to educate people about the disease and how to protect oneself from contracting it. There were a lot of messages about safe sex and using condoms. But over the years, as the threat from HIV lessened, the education efforts similarly lessened. As a result, a new generation of young people are coming of age and becoming sexually active without even the basic knowledge of HIV and how to protect themselves. How is HIV spread? 96% of HIV is transmitted through sexual intercourse, both vaginal and anal. Like all viruses, HIV doesn't care whether you're a man or a woman, or whether you identify yourself as gay, straight, or bisexual, or any other identity. It is a virus. It transmits through bodily fluids, which include blood, semen and seminal fluid, vaginal fluids, and even breast milk. However, it is not spread through saliva, as the chemical makeup of saliva is not conducive for the HIV virus to replicate and survive for long. HIV and oral sex, let's talk about that. Many people wonder if HIV is transmittable through oral sex. And the short answer is that the chances are very low, but not zero, as it is possible if the circumstances are there for transmission. However, in all the decades of research, there's been very little evidence to show that HIV is spread through oral sex. There are circumstances that can make transmission more likely, and these include having a cut in your mouth, which allows infected vaginal or seminal fluids to enter the body. If the man ejaculates in the mouth of the partner, that's one way that the risk is increased. If the woman is having her menstruation, her vaginal fluids are more likely to contain the virus from her blood. If the person has a higher viral load during the time of sex, for example, someone who was recently infected or at a late stage in their infection when the virus has multiplied. As body fluids are one of the major modes of transmission through sexual contact, the use of condoms has long been one of the most important safe sex recommendations. And for a long time, using condoms was the only way to protect yourself against contracting HIV, aside, of course, from celibacy. But in recent years, there's been a new class of medications that can protect people from contracting HIV. And these medications are called pre-exposure prophylaxis, or PrEP, PrEP. And these are antiviral drugs that stop the virus from replicating inside the body. PrEP medications are for people who do not have HIV, but who are at high risk of contracting HIV through their lifestyle, through their sexual practices. Unlike a vaccine, which is administered once or twice, these medications must be taken daily. If you then get exposed to HIV, they will keep the virus from forming a permanent infection in the body. It's important to keep in mind that this is a preventative medication, not a cure. So it's ineffective for those who already have HIV. When taken daily, PrEP is highly effective in preventing HIV. Studies have shown that it reduces the risk of getting HIV from sex by between 92 to 99% when taken daily. PrEP is much less effective if it is not taken consistently. Now, as PrEP only protects against HIV, condoms are still important for the protection against other sexually transmitted diseases. Because HIV's mode of transmission is through sexual contact or through IV drug use, it made the disease one that many people and governments found difficult to talk about, and for a long time, there was much fear, ignorance, shame, and misinformation about this disease. The world is more enlightened now, and with the power of education and science, we have made great advancements towards taming this killer disease. But the virus has not gone away. It remains in the world, ready to spread and kill, and we cannot go back to the dark days of ignorance and silence. These medications that control the virus are useless if people do not even know they are infected and if people do not get themselves tested regularly. You know, there's an old saying that the devil's greatest trick is convincing the world he doesn't exist. And the same is true for any virus, whether it's COVID-19 or HIV. Ignorance and denial of their existence is their greatest ally. If humanity is to survive, we must never forget that viruses are always with us and will keep killing us if we allow them to by our own ignorance and apathy. So the bottom line basically is that while HIV can be treated and can be effectively managed by people, both in preventative as well as in therapy, you need to know whether or not you have HIV. You need to be aware of this. And if most people are not getting themselves tested, then you won't know. And that is the great danger there. So that's it for this week on Health Zone with Gilbert Cheah. Thank you for joining us, and join us again next week for another episode.